Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the European division for the European qualifier, rather, for ESL 1 Frankfurt. It's Team Empire versus Danish Bears. I'm Capitalist. I'm going to be joined by Rio Burrows. What's up, Rio?
Oh, nothing much. Should be leaving here in another day to go to Star Ladder. And this will help me, you know, prepare for tomorrow a little bit or the next few days trying to cast here. I like having a warm up. It should be really fun.
Yeah.
You can tell me everything I do wrong, and then I'll fix it by when I get to Star Ladder. That's going to be perfect. No. Should be great. So why?
Sorry. I was talking to my IT guy.
Okay.
Sorry. Yeah. That's the reason I was angry, because there was stuff screwed up with the studio again, and
it's one of those studio mads. I got you.
Yeah. So. Yeah, I was just, you know, being angry at someone. But hey, I'm sorry. Congrats on Star Ladder, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. You excited?
Yeah. I might get a little bit nervous. You never know. Hopefully not. I should be fine on the camera.
You did TI4 group stage, man. You're gonna be fine.
Oh, this
you're
is,
gonna be
this
fine.
Is pennies in comparison. Pennies.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. So, besides, you get a nice little warm up here with Danish Bears versus Team Empire. Wait, how long till you leave?
I leave tomorrow around noonish.
On
my plane. Yep.
All right. Hope you don't die.
I know, right? I'm going out of the Belgian airport. So, we're at Brussels. Hopefully no shenanigans there.
Yeah, you know, my dad was actually, my dad went through that airport like two, his flight got delayed because of that incident. It was pretty crazy. Team Empire's turn. Anyway, let's talk about the Dota at hand. Earth Spirit, Zeus, Witch Doctor, Inspector. Team Empire going to go for a global lineup, while Danish Bears, they have a global hero on their own with the Dangerous Prophet. And they also have a lot of pushing power combination with the Chen. They pick up the Rubik, which is... I'm still not really understanding why some teams choose to pick up Rubik. That it just kind of throws me off sometimes, but it's here. So that's that.
I would agree with you. When teams pick it up in this situation, you're like, is this Nullfeld really going to do something? Because that's the biggest thing sticking out besides, you know, a disable, which you can get from a lot of the other heroes. And you're not stealing any of the great spells in this game. I mean, the funny part is when I wanted to Ice Frog to maybe fix Earth Spirit so you could at least give some of the boulders over to Rubik when you steal them. And then at least Earth Spirit spells would be viable or something. But in this case, Rubik is not going to benefit from much unless you get like ags on him and then geometric grip somebody back. But yeah, like you said, this is Team Global versus a well-sustained team, I guess, coming from the Danish Bears and push strats. So if it's looking right now, it's kind of stock standard. If Team Empire can hold out for look like 25, 30 minutes, they should be in a good time where Danish Bears kind of want to put the pressure on early right now and try to finish this game relatively soon before Spectre gets online.
Juggernauts now for Danish Bears. More pushing power. Jesus, they're just... I mean, I really like Juggernaut versus Spectre. I think the biggest concern I have is... I think they just need to get an aggressive hero for mid against the Zeus, because they have the rotating Chen and Rubik that's going to be able to come into the mid lane, and then they have the Nature's Prophet who can TP in. I think they put pressure on the Zeus during the laning phase. They try and mess with him as much as possible because he's going to be number one obstacle when Danish Bears try and go high ground.
Yeah, even for these towers outside, like you're talking about, he'll have an Aether Lens relatively short if he's not contested in that mid lane. He's going to sit back, Arcane Bolt, defend the towers. And yeah, that's their biggest problem is how are they going to get on top of them? And without having, well, both teams need, well, Team Empire need an offlane hero here. I'm trying to figure out what they're going for first before I think Danish Bears, but they need... I'm trying to figure out what's going to help. I mean, the Darkseer plus Earth Spirit combo is still there. Can put pressure, make sure that the Juggernaut stays in that lane, that Rubik as well. Like you mentioned, the Rubik and Chen would... they can have a really nice time rotating around the map if they don't pick... if they pick a greedy offlane here for Team Empire. Mm-hmm. But they might want to go back for an Earthshaker too. And just so they can have, you know, the group up initiation. If Danish Bears get too clumped, you have that huge Echo Sam play with all the creeps. So,
yeah.
See where they want to go.
Do you think there's any danger of them picking, say you do go for an Earthshaker, do you think there's any danger of Danish Bears then getting more of like a carry style mid and then just pushing this late? Because initially we're looking at this and going, Danish Bears are going to be the aggressors. They're going to be the ones pushing into, establishing control, trying to end the game before Spectre gets too big. But with the Darkseer, that is definitely suitable enough late game power that I'm sure Danish Bears just want to end it as fast as possible.
Yep. I mean, the wall combo when you're defending, if he has a Blink Dagger, can very scary, as you're talking about, for the high ground defense. But Danish Bears, if they have an Aegis online, Juggernaut can go to the front lines, deal out a ton of damage on the tower, and they can pick up another tempo controlling mid here, like remaining. Queen of Pain now, trying to figure out what else can really take it to Zeus early on. I mean, Zeus is one of those heroes that is going to win just the lane by CSing. He's not going to win in denies or getting out, you know, outplaying the enemy hero. But okay, that's a good hero. It's kind of Zeus versus Ember. It's kind of a weird situation where you're like, oh, I have my flame guard, but it's instantly taken off from me. But they even might put the Juggernaut in the mid lane here, which could be interesting. But I love Ember Spirit. When you're running a global strategy like this, you get the boots of travel, you go around the map constantly fighting. And they're just going to be, it looks like both teams are going to just constantly fight right now. And this is going to be looking like a really fun game.
Yeah, definitely. Danish Bears. How do you think how does the matchup go? Ember Spirit versus Zeus. How good is that for Zeus? It's not overly so, right?
Yeah, it's not, but it's probably one of the better situations for him, where you can at least deal with the Flame Guard. Most of the time, it's hard to deal with that without having like a Queen of Pain or something. But in this case, Zeus will have a better time, I want to say, than against other heroes like the Queen of Pain, like the Invoker with the Forged Spirits and the Exhort. So should help him out at least getting more done in the mid lane. And then Ember Spirit, is he susceptible to the ganks now, Cap, from the Earth Spirit? It's going to be the question.
Yeah, that's actually... Ember Spirit's, I would say, a relatively easy hero to gank just because his positioning is oftentimes pretty forward. So this will definitely open a lot of opportunities for Earth Spirit. But then again, we're talking about Danish Bears. Like, I'm expecting them to be leaving the Juggernaut alone at the bottom lane. Oftentimes to be able to get the double support rotation from their Chen and Rubick into that mid lane.
That's why I was very curious why they didn't just put Juggernaut in the mid lane and then Ember safe. I guess you would still be getting a lot of harassment coming out from the Darkseer, so you're just kind of trading off like, well, I'd rather have my Juggernaut being able to spin off all the damage coming in from Ion Shells than my Ember Spirit kind of left on his own, but...
Yeah, he doesn't have a good way to be able to deal with Ion Shell. That would be kind of problematic, seeing as Flame Guard probably wouldn't last long. In those early levels, at least.
30 seconds to battle.
Scouting out Tree here. It's going to be seeing their position. Now they might... Yeah, they might try to run for the top rune. I thought immediately Danish Bears would go to the top, scouting out all the heroes there, but... Are they going to contest this? The question is, who wins this? It's 3v4. I think Empire is going to win this handily.
Yeah, with the Ion Shell, it's really dangerous. All they really have is Ace's spin. And Ryze can't actually contest top because Ramses is already there. And he's got the dagger and everything already set out to get back up to that top lane nice and quick. So that rather unfortunate scenario there for Danish Bears. They just do not have the level 1 power to be able to do anything about that. The only way that could possibly change is if they had the Furion in the mid or at the top lane with the Chen. Maybe together they could have contested that.
Yep. Mid lane, already going to go in for the boulder roll here on Penguin. This is how the harassment starts, and when you hit that first one, it always feels good for the Earth Spirit because you're just able to take away a lot of the region. But going back there, the only way to contest, right, I think they could have gotten the kill on Empire, but then Empire maybe would have gotten, you know, a double or triple kill. That was going to be the bigger problem.
Yeah.
Because they do have a lot of burst with the Juggernaut. But
Darkseer will be able to get his level 2, so his laning phase is already looking pretty good. Not much that Ruby can really do to zone this hero out when you start off with the double ion shelled wave. They tried to go for a deny or two in order to prevent Afterlife from being able to get that fast. Because that's the thing. When you're dealing with the Darkseer, he'll always double ion shell. He'll always kind of run at you with that first wave. And if you don't deny anything, he gets a free level 2. But if you deny, you might be able to, with the right kind of support, zone him out and keep him from getting that critical surge. But unfortunately, Rubik's just not strong enough, and Afterlife was able to soak some experience there in the jungle while the lane was pushed, and now should have a pretty easy lane. I highly doubt a telekinesis spin is ever going to be enough to kill Afterlife, because he can always surge immediately afterwards. So they'd have to do something. They'd have to be somehow get Darkseer in a position where they're able to hit him with a telekinesis after he's already surged, which is unlikely.
Yeah, I think it can come to fruition if they do get off the boots on Ace before the Darkseer. But like you're saying, once he gets level 4, the Darkseer is just going to be able to run away in time. It's just going to be these first levels that could cause a problem. And, you know, Ace can't even get to the shot right now. But meanwhile, have a lot of poking and prodding here with the Nature's Prophet and Misha.
Miposhka?
How do you say his name by it?
Miposhka.
Miposhka.
Yeah.
It's going to be a fun name.
Yeah. They had a suspicion that maybe Furion actually had a ward in this area because he was blocking out. He essentially, Hester Joe's been playing very protective over his offlane camp.
Is he going to get first play?
Almost. I mean, if he hit that one, Miposhka would have dropped probably down to like 10 or 20 HP. But there was a miss and there was a Voodoo Restoration. Now he's going to heal back up fully. Hester Joe, thinking for a second that means that he can actually go to lane, but with the Earth Spirit already fully healed up, Hester Joe is going to be immediately jumped on when he shows his face with the dagger and the follow-up from the Earth Spirit landing. First blood going to Ramses.
Really well-executed rotations coming in. Normally, Earth Spirit, sometimes when you can't get anything done in the mid lane, you want to go to off lane, mid, and Scandal mid lane. Looking like they wanted to TPN, but they're not going to do it. And speaking about the mid lane, we haven't really touched on it here for the last minute or two, and they just constantly been shockwaving the poor guy here over for Scandal, and he's just getting that's why you see him on 14 CFs compared to the 20 of the Ember. But hurting right now is the Juggernaut. I want to say he missed a lot of last hits under the tower because of the pressure from the Darkseer, and that's just going to help out the Spectre a lot, especially when they already got the first blood over on Ramses.
Yeah, that pressure is really not going to let up either. Ace has to get these couple more last hits so we can get the phase boots and have that big increase in damage. That way it just becomes a whole lot easier for him underneath the tower.
He still has 1K gold.
I know.
I think he could have went to the side shop once in the past, you know, minute or two, but opting not to go for anything. Still needs to get that Basilius up for the mana regen. And he has a healing ward level too. I don't know when's the last time I saw this with no crit on your Juggernaut. I mean, that helps out a lot when you're trying to clear up the creep with the Iron Shell on it early. So a bit confused there. But obviously more sustain to the push is going to help out a lot in this mid game.
Chen is already level 4. Damn, I didn't watch his jungle at all, but this has to be some Wild Wing Ripper tornado stacks that he was able to abuse. Because there's no way that you use the first creep that you get harassing Scandal in the mid lane like you were talking about and still have this good of levels on Chen. Unless you're stacking while you're also harassing, and then you clear through it with the Wild Wing Ripper. And that's just sometimes comes down to a little bit of luck. The DD is going to be denied, and they're actually going to be able to pull Scandal back. They barely hit the clap, but barely is good enough to be able to slow him down and right-click him all the way through. Very well played by Danish Bears. Nice rotation from the supports. Really surprised, though, that Zeus went for the bottom lane rune rather than the top lane, which should have been secured by his supports.
Oh, mid lane King R is just playing really aggressive here, not having level 6 for Penguin. Else he might have dived that.
That's pretty awkward. Oh, TPN. Missed Boulder, though. Pinkvin check is going to lose his Flame Guard, but that's going to be it. Miposhka That's enough for a kick. They're actually still going to follow this one out, bringing Pinfinchek very low. The Fairy Fire not keeping him alive. Witch Doctor will be able to score that kill. Top, meanwhile, top lane. Jesus. Ramsey's diving in deep, but it works. He gets the Furion directly underneath that Tier 2 tower.
That's a huge kill, too, because you're denying a lot of this EXP coming in from the Furion. That's like two waves right now. You can see. He's just going to TP in here. Just respawning here, but that's his urn now up for Ramsey's, and he's going to have Haunt available. So what he wants to do is just probably TP back to base here and look for a kill. Where can they make one happen? It looks like still Penguin's not level 6. They could set it up for him, but he should have it here shortly.
Yeah, this rotation from Witch Doctor is just going to refill the bottle of Zeus, but it shouldn't actually get the kill on the Ember Spirit. Just needs one more creep. That is something to say, is that Empire are lacking when it comes to lockdown. This is why the Ember Spirit last pick felt pretty good in some aspects, because their best hero for locking down the Ember Spirit is the Earth Spirit, obviously with his kick and silence. But even that is a bit unreliable. Everything else is even more so. Like, for example, the Paralyzing Cast is pretty bad. Pinfinchek, whoa, man. Manages to sidestep that rolling boulder on in. Miposhka does manage to grab the Illusion Rune, though, denying it from our Ember Spirit.
And they're still getting hungry here. They smoked up. They don't have the silence yet. So I don't know if they can really catch Penguin here. He's playing very defensive, too.
Oh, they're going to full wrap around behind Afterlife. Oh, but the Spectre ult's been going down. It's going to scout them out. Pinfinchek is going to be able to get away from this attempted gank on mid lane. How is Afterlife not aware of this? He's sticking like he's A-OK, but he's already so low in HP. He should be playing a lot more careful. And yeah, they are going to be able to catch him out here. Clap, easily finishing him off. And now they'll take that Tier 1 tower. The Furion, I'm not even sure if his rotation is needed. Ryze, look out for King R. But with a Chen creeps plus the healing ward, the Tier 1 tower should be very easy to take. Furion, his presence not even being required.
Yeah, punishing them for... I'm just very curious why he saw the Haunt and then he didn't go back either. I'm very curious why that kind of happened as well. But that's going to mean another for first Tier 1 tower. Meanwhile, top lane, this is going to be... Oh, no.
Ooh, the TP in. They're going to try and punish. I don't think Hester Joe gets out of here alive, but maybe Pinfinchek can get a return kill. He wanted it on Ramses, that he actually leaves Miposhka to die to the tower. Sloppy there from Pinfinchek, who, if his Remnant had been placed a little bit more on point the first one, he could have gotten a chains on the Spectre and maybe turned that into a double kill. But as is, he's just going to have to accept a lowly support kill instead.
That's, you can't have those missed kills, especially on a Spectre, because we talked about how she had a really amazing game so far in this early stage. She's 2-0. She already got the Urn Boots. She has the almost the highest CS still in the game. So not shutting her down right now, it's going to escalate to a snowball effect for Empire, and they need to find whatever pickoffs they can to slow down the Spectre. And the other good thing coming out from Empire will be the Zeus now has his level 7, and then he didn't go for this greedy Arc Lightning build. Normally when you're Zeus, and I'll admit to this, when I play in the mid lane, I always go to an Arc Lightning so I can instantly CS no matter what in the mid lane. But since he has this huge burst damage, max Lightning Bolt already, they can get very greedy. And because it doesn't look like Danish Bears are in a position to make anything because their lanes are all pushed out right now, they'll have the Spectre Haunt up in 37 seconds, and it looks like Empire is going to be able to still dictate the next team fight. So how do Danish Bears kind of put the pressure on them? We talked about them. They needed to have a really good early game here. Should they go rotate around in the mid lane or try to take over the enemy jungle? Who's their prime target right now?
I mean, I still go back to what I was talking about in the draft. I really think that they should smoke up again and put pressure on the Zeus. I mean, you have this support duo that is pretty good. This is one thing, like, I'm not a big fan of Rubick. I don't think either one of us are, but it is a really good combo hero with the Chen specifically when you're ganking together, just because that long duration telekinesis, that hold, and then also being able to move the hero closer to the Chen creeps, you know, that actually serves as a really good setup ability. And they got to use that. They got to use that to be constantly ganking that mid lane, shut down the Zeus, take that tier 1 tower. I mean, you have not only that ganking duo, but you also have this Nature's Prophet who has this kind of global presence in the game. You know, they really should have been able to, I think, shut Scandal out more than they have. At the very least, you know, if you can't actually get the successful gank on him, take that tower before the 10-minute mark. That definitely feels like a necessity. You shouldn't let Scandal feel safe sitting here in the mid lane farming away.
Yeah, they decided to go for the bottom tower, but like you said, that's just going to shut down the Darkspur, who was already shut down, and that's going to allow him to get back into this game with farm. He's already level 6 now because they didn't really pull back the lane fast enough. And then, yeah, Scandal's just going to be able to free farm here in the mid lane. And they, like you talked about, how are Empire going to set up ganks now for themselves when they have no smokes online? So let's see. They have 2 smokes in base. They heavily rely on Earth Spirit right now to get anything done. And we'll just have to see the support rotations coming in from Empire.
Yeah. I mean, I'm still kind of okay with Empire's position in this game just because the Zeus is doing all right for himself. Like, look, he's going to have this big old stack. He's actually going to catch up with the Ember Spirit with this. And then the Spectre is, you know, staying in range with the Juggernaut. I think this is all pretty good signs for Empire. Those 2 cores success, even if the Darkseer falls a little bit far behind. This is definitely an interesting rotation, though. Danish Bear is fully rotating Ace as well as Ryze out of that bottom lane. They're going to go up top with a smoke and try and catch the Spectre. So if this is successful, this is a big-time win. They're going to lead, get the chains. They have the spin. Oh, Ramzes definitely should be dead unless, oh, the kick slows down Pinkman check, and Ramzes gets into the trees. Hester Joe throws Treants after him, and Ramzes is going to have to somehow kite his way through, but he just runs straight into Hester Joe with that Flame Guard burn. Hester Joe is going to be the one who picks up the kill, though. Sorry, the Nature's Prophet.
I think that's a really big misplay coming in from your Spectre. It's one of those situations where even though you use your haunt and it'll be on cooldown, at least you can make that attempt to get away. Whereas he just like sits there and is not getting anything accomplished. And when your Spectre dies like that, it sets up for that tower and then now for this tier 2 push. And they didn't even have to, you know, commit any big ultimates really from the side of Danish Bears besides the Furion ulti. So if they really wanted to, maybe they could have still put pressure on, but giving a lot of respect to Empire and don't want to really necessarily push into the Zeus, as we talked about. And so they're just going to go back farming now.
We got drums on the Juggernaut. Ember Spirit is about to complete Boots of Travel. Boots of Travel is really good with Chen. Oh, Ace!
Silence?
Oh, he's not going to be able to get away from this one. He spins, but the right click from Ramzes is going to be enough. Rubick also dies at the same time, so a nice couple of pickups there for Empire, using their first combination of the Zeus and Spectre ultimates quite successfully.
Yeah, they just hung around a long time, maybe trying to set up a kill on the Spectre farming alone, but didn't realize the Earth Spirit's kind of behind them. They had this ward already set up. Maybe this is what helped Scout out to punish the Stainless Bears from going very aggressive on their side. So really well played from Empire, and that's what I was talking about. Like you said, they're not in a rush to get anything done with the Empire's lineup. They just want to steadily increase the farm on the Spectre. But when their ultis are up, I still do think they can make plays around the map. It's just when and where is a question. And
yeah,
they made a good timely gank right then. And then Ramzes is going to have his drums very shortly. So you're going to see the bad man build. Are you a fan of it? Is there any other thing you could really get out of it?
I like it. For the most part, I think that there are very few games where you should be going like a straight Radiance kind of build. I think getting the phase boots, as well as I think sometimes you can bypass the urn, but that's kind of dependent on if you have another good ganking hero. Kingar's gonna die in the mid lane. Danish Bear is surrounding that mid. I like how Danish Bears are picking up the pace though. You know, I was concerned essentially. You know, I was kind of concerned. I was a bit critical about the fact that they weren't putting pressure on Scandal, like I felt was kind of a necessity. But they've really picked up the pace with that rotation to top lane at smoke. Successful gank. They took the tier one. Now they get a gank on mid. Take that tier one as well. You know, all these tier one towers are gone by 13 minutes. I think that's a pretty good tempo for Danish Bears. And they just got to keep this up, essentially, and work their way through the tier twos and go also for Roshan. You know, it's kind of those setup objectives before you start going high ground.
Right. And this might all come down to like one Rosh. If Danish Bears win it, they could be, you know, the favorites for the rest of the game. Whereas Empire, they kind of need to find a way to clash there, deny the Aegis from Danish Bears. And meanwhile, bottom lane, they got the kick set up, almost dodged by that.
Nice silence, good control on Pinkvincheck. This is exactly what you have to see here from Miposhka. Now, Ramzi is also going to run down Ryze, as he was obviously alone in the jungle, as he's wont to do as a Chen. He gets off the heal, Hasta Joe's going to come in. They actually have the Rubick here as well. The toss back, they're going to be able to slow him down with the bear as well as sprout him in. The rest of Empire finally comes in. Nice double kick there from Miposhka. It's going to be able to get off his ultimate still, though. The mech did come in, and it helps save Ryze for the time being, but it looks like both supports are still going to go down. But Ace is spinning right through everyone. He gets two, might even get a third here. Afterlife managed to get the vacuum off, but won't slow down that Omni Slash as it sticks onto that offlaner. Hasta Joe going too far, though, as Ramzi still have that Ion Shell on him, and they quickly blow up the Furion and now turn towards Ace, who's obviously out of ammo. He has nothing left after you spin as well as Omni Slash. The Boots of Travel going to come in, but Scandal is away. Pinkvincheck going to chase down Ramzi's instead and should be able to get that kill, as the dagger kind of fruitless there, as he's still stuck inside the chains. Danish Bears, I don't even know what to make of that one. The fight recap obviously showing 5 dead there for 4 on Team Empire. Obviously successful for Empire as a whole, but some of that engagement was just odd for Danish Bears, like Hesta Joe just running at the Spectre and Zeus alone, thinking that somehow he could do something there.
Once again, everything is just set up by the Earth Spirit. Really well played, everything. All the silences, the kick. And like you said, they just punished for their really greedy play coming in from Danish Bears. And I mean, you don't even have your Rubick level 6 during that team fight. You already used the Hand of God from the Chen to just escape the death from the Spectre. So you don't have these big ultimates online or game-changing, you know, plays. And then I would say it's about even at the end of the day, though. Ace got that triple kill, which is going to help him escalate to that next item. The Battle Fury is what he wants to go for. And then the Ember Spirit there getting that dominating spree coming in from Ramzi's is going to help him go for his Battle Fury as well. So at the end of the day, Danish Bears still looking good here. Going to be applying the pressure now.
Too many Ion Shells to deal with. Ace spins it down. They lose one of their Chen creeps, but it looks like their push is still going to go through. They get the kick. The initiation comes out. They're going to blow up Ace almost immediately. He's still silenced and will end up going down. That spin being used early may have just cost him his life, as now Danish Bears without their Juggernaut are just food for Empire. Bounce around. Looks like they stopped the Rubick from being able to TP out. Hesta Joe will be able to get a Sprout in the way. Right click. Oh, the just barely coming out from Ramzi's. The earned damage is enough. Pinkvincheck is the only one to be able to survive through that fight, and while the last engagement might have been kind of meh, slightly favorable to Empire and all those sorts of things, you still expected Danish Bears to be able to come back and do fine in some of these, you know, 15 and 25 minute engagements, but that one was just brutal. That was a 0-for-4 trade-off that now Empire get total control of the Radiant side jungle.
That's what happens when you don't ban Earth Spirit and then he has an amazing game. I'm worried because the combo is not even there yet. When Darkseer starts getting, you know, vacuum wall combination with the Boulder Smash, oh man, Team Empire, how good is their coordination going to be for me? Because they're certainly playing very well as a team so far here. And with that last team fight, Darkseer going to be picking up the mechanism already. And oh, it's looking very bad for Danish Bears, but with those big ultimates on cooldown, it kind of feels like they want to start you know, keep pressuring, keep pressuring. It's like the same thing when you're playing against a silencer or something, or a black hole. You just want to constantly pressure when, you know, Zeus Spectre ulti is on cooldown, but they, since they're just wiped from the face of the earth, they have to push out their lane still, and then they still have to group up. So maybe Danish Bears, they might just do a 180 right now, Cap, and they might just try to go for the later game with having double Battle Fury and just try to beat them in the later stage.
Yeah, that may actually be their best option, in which case Empire, just with some of these early wins and with the way that we know they're going to transition, they should actually hit a really big peak at about like 30, 35 minutes, I would say, when you get the completed Manta and Diffusal for the Spectre, the Zeus. His damage output is already very good. He just needs to be able to get some of those later game items now, because his farm's actually really nice. Veil of Discord as well as Aether Lens already up. If he can get maybe a little bit of mobility items, Yule Scepter wouldn't be bad, I guess, against a Juggernaut Omnislash. That's probably the first and foremost item.
I think Yule's, like you said, and then Blink, Yule's a Blink, or Yule's Force Staff maybe, because the Sprout could be very disastrous for certain heroes.
True, true. Mm-hmm. That's a good point.
But, yeah, I would definitely say Yule's first for the obvious reasons. You know, taking on Immer Spirit, Searing Change, Juggernaut, Omnislash, and mainly for those. But Empire, got to feel good about themselves right now. They picked up a cloak already on the Witch Doctor, and it looks like these supports are just going to be setting up anything. We haven't seen a really good Death Ward yet coming out from King R, but they're trying to set it up here. Nobody's taking the bait just yet.
Really hasn't been too necessary with Miposhka going so ham on the Earth Spirit. That Glimmer Cape is definitely going to be a great pickup. They don't have the counter vision. You could see certain things like Omnislash or maybe even Ember Spirit trying to go on somebody, but that ends up failing because of the Glimmer. Or as you said, we may see a really good Death Ward because of that channeling invisibility as well.
So what do you go for Earth Spirit now, Cap? I mean, you have the Veil already on the Zeus. What's his next item? I see some people just go Blade Mail. At times you just boulder in and just you're like, hey, target me, and is it a Lotus Orb game? I mean, is it too early to talk about Ags?
I think utility at this point is probably his best bet. Of course, it's easy for me to say that now that I see Staff of Wizardry and a Ring of Regen. So obviously Jeter. He's going to be going for Staff. But I think it makes decent amount of sense. There's just, you're right, between the Veil already being picked up. Like, he could go something like Aether Lens or Spirit, you know. You're right, because the Veil Discord is normally the big item, and then they already have, like, mech, so some of the sustain options are already covered. I should say mech, but he's actually got a completed Guardian Greaves. So his item choices are, most of the traditional ones are a little bit limited. Top lane, they're going to roll in on Ryze with the Spectre Ultimate and the Death Ward. That one is super easy. Looks like he went over to Hesta Joe and the Nature's Prophet as the Spectre and tried to threaten him, but that was just an immediate TP out. So Spectre runs back to the top lane where they take that tier 1 tower. Nature's Prophet actually going for a Necronomicon.
That's weird.
Yeah, that is weird. I mean, I'm not expecting a mech build, obviously, because we have a Chen, but it's not exactly common to see a Necronomicon.
Yeah, we talked about it, how they were going to make the shift, though, top lane. Once again, the boulder kick in, silence, baby. Oh, my goodness.
It just keeps on happening, time after time.
And that's the problem I was going to talk about here. It's when you... he's going to kill him. Potion's going to kill himself because of the Necro. That was funny, but I was going to talk about it. It's when you start playing defensively like this against the Spectre and the Zeus, and they're trying to go for this later game scenario with their two cores, you're just going to constantly get picked off around the map because of their global pressure. But so you're going to have to figure they are going to feed some of these kills over every single time that the cooldown is off. So Danish Bears, they have to be a little bit careful where they go around the map now, because they still need to get that next item, right? They just got their Battle Fury on the Ember, on the Juggernaut. They still need... I'm trying to figure out what's the best thing for them next, right, Cap? Like, do you want to get extra defensive Manta style maybe for the Juggernaut, for the Silence on the Earth Spirit, or do you want to just what do you want to do?
Maybe you even consider just going all out BKB, because team fights are getting pretty rough right now, and a large part of that is the magic damage. So if he does get silenced, he has that to be able to defend him, and then this also just means a lot of added strength where he could just kind of run in, right-click people, Omni-Slash, and have the spin to still fall back on after all that has been burned through.
I like BKB a lot. Sometimes...
Spectre ultimate goes down. Looks like they catch Ryze. Again, a little bit of deja vu in this top lane. I think Ryze just wanted to send Pingvin check back to base and allow him to run it back in, but that little helping hand ends up costing him his life.
Man, they're just scouting now with Zeus ulti. Maybe potential Danish bears were going to do Roche with the Furion, but he's in the bottom lane just pushing out now. And we didn't get to touch like you talked about on the Necro book. I would have really liked to see the Ags instead of the Necro. I mean, it gives you even more split pushing power than the Necro. It gives you more survivability. Trying to figure out what other purpose this Necro book's going to help out for the most, but maybe somebody kills himself. I mean, we almost saw it with Mapushka, so maybe they'll get lucky on that front.
That is true. Danish Bears, their three-man smoke, rotate over. Oh, this is going to be awkward. Their smoke has already been revealed by Mapushka, who's going to be able to get a free silence, and now a kick onto Ace, slowing him down. The Rubik's already dead, and Ace is just... Oh, he's looking for the Omni-Slash, but Force Staff actually disjointing that one. Ace bounces back over to the neutrals. Ace has to spin and TP out, but that was so bad. Yes, they only lost to Rubik. It could have been perhaps even worse, but considering that was one of their kind of almost desperation smokes, this is the way that Danish Bears need to get back into this game, was successful smoke rotations like that. And
oh, no.
Now Pingvin check. He's going to bounce back over to Afterlife.
He already has TP, though.
He's got another Remnant. King R is there. This guy just has no escapes. He's out of mana. They're going to dagger him. The dagger's going to catch up eventually, and Afterlife's just going to punch him. Ion Shell blinks in front of him. Body blocks him a little bit. Pingvin check ends up going down 9-20. Empire in a commanding lead now. They may not have the full map control with that tier 1 still up, but I think you can tell right now with their push in mid, they want to actually take that away from Danish Bears, and we'll really see how Empire are controlling this game.
Yeah, like you said, Danish Bears are very lucky with not having the Juggernaut ulti. They're not getting punished more by Empire doing Roche. Their lineup is atrocious. They didn't, you know, go for a medallion or anything to help out with it. So it's going to come down to, I don't even know, Spectre with a defusal. Still not screaming Roche. Still no negative armor on the Roche. So it's going to be interesting how they kind of tackle the big boy. But they're pressuring here mid lane. Spectre Haunt is up. If he gets another mana burn on him, Ramses won't have enough. Oh, he didn't micro. Hestia Joe. Friend. Radiant's middle tower
has fallen. And this will now mean defusal for Ramses. They see a stack. I think if Empire put a premium on blocking out that ancient stack, they just, you know, throw counter ward after the counter ward, taking that one away. I really don't see how Danish Bears gets both of their cores to the point where they'll need to be in order to contest the Spectre. Because it's just too hard with losing this much map control and having three cores that all farm. You have to be able to take as much advantage of the neutrals as possible, and Ancient is obviously going to be your biggest opportunity to do so. But that stack is taken away by Empire. Things are going to get real nasty. Oh, Mishposhka, he sees this one. He's going to get the silence on Ace. No! Misses it barely. The spin goes off just in time. Bottom lane. Ramses is going to go for the quick kill on Noya. So quick, in fact, that he couldn't even complete the TP in time.
It's just not fair, man. You play these supports, you can't even get Ghost Scepters anymore. Nice silence on the mid Mapushka, but not going to get anything out of that. Poor little Rubik. What is he, 0-5? As we talked about, this is not a Rubik game, guys. You just basically lift people up early on with the Chen, and that's all she wrote for the poor guy.
Yeah. Now Ramses, Necronomicon is actually going to play against Danish Bears in some ways, because Ramses is rapidly farming these things now that he has so much damage, the Manta style and Diffusal Blade. So he just got a free 300 gold at the top lane.
What is their strategy now? I think Danish Bears will look really good in maybe 20 minutes or even 40. Like, you have to hold on for the super, super late game where Empire, all they have is kind of like magic damage.
Yeah.
And then you're going to have the Juggernaut and the Ember. Like you said, they both desperately need BKBs at this stage because you're just going to get defuseled and run down with the Spectre. So there's no other way to really go.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's kind of like one of those lineups that, like, Danish Bears, they look they're supposed to look really strong in, like, 15, 20 minutes, put a lot of pressure, take towers and such. But
oh, Hestia.
If it goes super late, they may actually be able to have something. But Hestia Joe should still die. TP out, not going to be good enough. And Danish Bears, more pickoffs happen. The darker this game's looking for them. Scandal and Pingvin
Check.
Speaking
of dark, Scandal.
Yeah. They're passing by each other. Afterlife's going to come in. Misses the Guardian. Grease. Scandal's going to be able to. Oh, the Spectre ult! It soaks up the Omni Slash from Ace. So damn unlucky. And Ramses even gets the kill on Chen. Of course, you know, we're looking at that attempt from the Omni Slash. But Ramses, as soon as he pops that, he's going to be looking for a pickoff on one of those supports. And it's a free kill every time.
That's no way that's intentional. Else I'm gonna give huge props, but no, it could have been. But he might have just had his eyes on the juicy Chen in the mid lane. But man, if that helped out his buddy there with Scandal, whoo, that was great stuff in Empire here in the game one.
Fury and ult damage easily undone by the Guardian Greaves from Afterlife as they take this tier two. Not much the Danish Bears can really do at this point in time, and it's going to be kind of the theme of the game, I feel like, for the next 15 minutes, is most of the time Empire now going to be the ones pushing into you, and Danish Bears just have to split push and try and trade as much as possible.
How much can they trade is going to be the question right now. Ember Spirit is going for this all-out kind of crit, going to be holding out the high ground. And Juggernaut still hasn't completed his Manta style, if he's still going to go for that route to help out with the silences. And I don't know, the item progression is still not there from okay, there it is, I lied. But if Ace gets caught out right now, this could mean Empire don't really have the best high ground siege, but so that could help them out once this game keeps going later. Uh-oh. And later.
Has to Joe, he's not quite pop. Scandal needs another couple rounds. Ace unfortunately doesn't have his Omni Slash just yet, but hey, he doesn't even need it with the Ruby coming across. Zeus kind of took a chance there, ended up getting bit in the butt. Now Afterlife is going to get back to Maposhka. They are going to be able to get the silence onto Pingvincheck, holding him in. Nice vacuum as well into the wall. They blow up Pingvincheck, and Ace immediately with the spin TP out as Ramses pops that ultimate. He knew as soon as he heard the sounds of the Spectre that fight was going to go the way of Empire. So even if they lost their Zeus in rather a silly way, didn't quite matter. Danish Bears still drop 1-3, and Empire looks like this is going to be their opportunity to go Roshan. Even though, as you said, they don't have a great lineup for it, eventually they'll just get strong enough they can do it no matter what.
I'm just watching to see how fast it goes. It's pretty good timing here.
Yeah.
Big guy's gonna go clap, and
I mean,
it will take a long time.
Spectre used to be really garbage at doing Roshan, but now it's not so bad with Desolate proccing on Rosh.
And you also have the, I think you have the defuse. Well, that's a good question. Do you get the defusal here?
I'm sure defusal burn doesn't do anything.
Yeah. Rip old days where,
yeah,
you know, anti-mage doing the Rosh was semi-fast because you could just burn all his mana.
The unlimited source of mana for Lion.
Oh, yeah. That was
like 2,000 mana or something.
He went back for this Radiance though on Ramses. Very interesting to see this.
No, I think that's the right play.
Yeah, it's very good until the enemy team gets BKBs, but he's going to absolutely shred everybody else. So Ember Spirit and the Juggernaut are going to be the only ones surviving, and just on sheer numbers alone, Empire are just going to overwhelm them.
Yeah. And this will, like, it'll progress his farm as well. So we know that the Spectre is going to be super farm, like, six slotted by probably 45, 50 minutes max.
Right.
If he can actually get Butterfly next, you know there's not going to be any MKBs out of the Juggernaut or Ember Spirit for a while.
I want to see how aggressive Ramses plays, right? You say Butterfly, it probably is the best situation here, but because a lot of times you see this Juggernaut in my face constantly TPing out with a spin, you're just like, I want to get an Abyssal Blade because I want to make sure this guy doesn't go anywhere. I swear, man, you can get in the mind of some of the players. I swear, Eternal Envy would just do that just to spite that person.
Ember Spirit's going to get away before Mapochka comes in. Looks like he was spotted out. They tried to Glimmer Cape from the Witch Doctor and put Earth Spirit in a place where he could get the surprise kick in silence. But no such luck there. More Chen creeps going to be interrupted. Keeps on losing them. First it was Ramses, now Witch Doctor.
What is the odds right now for Danish Bears to... Oh, that was an almost nice combo coming in, but... What is the odds of Danish Bears kind of coming back in this game right now? It's
I would
very
say like,
bleak.
Yeah, I would say it's close to like 10% or something.
I get it around there. I was going to say that.
Once you get to this point for Empire's lineup, it's just really easy to execute. The biggest problem that they have is going high ground, but Empire don't have to worry about that for a while. I think they could actually just control the map, slowly take tier 2s for like probably another 10 minutes. They could almost wait for the next Roshan before attempting high ground. That may be a little bit too conservative, but it kind of serves to emphasize my point in that, you know, Empire can just control the game and push this late and just get a larger and larger net worth advantage because they've got so many good pickoff opportunities.
They're just hunting Penguin.
Yeah, they don't care about anything else. Mapochka was running through that jungle. Looks like they are still... No, Ace gets away again with the old spin and TP out.
He would have killed off Furion if he just went to the top lane. Like, he was on 300 HP, but Ramses unfortunately decided to go for Ace instead. And meanwhile, kind of cutting him off from the backside. Estia Joe...
Yeah.
I passed.
Ramses, you silly goose. Gets him with the defusal. Sprout goes down. Hesta Joe going to be continually slowed out here. Looks like they still got the kill. Ace sitting on the side, waiting for the rest of his team, thinking maybe they could do something here. Maybe an overextension from Empire, but rather it's Danish Bears who are going to overextend themselves. Spectre goes from one support, actually hunting down the next. Long-range defusal blade's going to be able to catch Ryze, blow him up as well. Ace, meanwhile, he's kind of been dancing around, finally is forced to use the spin, but this time around, he doesn't have a TP out. He had just used it, so he blinks over to the side. He's going to buy time here, but... I'm not sure if he's actually going to be able to get out of this situation with the Scythe of Ice and now surrounded by enemies on all sides. He ends up going down. Mapochka, just a casual Earth Spirit.
Hey, he's got
smacking
Vlad's.
Tier 3s.
He's got the push.
Yeah.
Pushing power.
He does.
And this is just slowly going down to 1% now for Danish Pairs. They're looking pretty much out of this game, and even if they go for the high ground, they have so much to kind of catch out Danish Bears too. Like, you just Spectre Haunt, ulti Zeus, and then everybody's like at half life or something, and then they could just dive in with blink daggers. But they should fake back here. How long do they have left with the Aegis? No, it should be expiring here soon. So
looks like
gonna
a minute
go
and
back.
A half. So, oh no, never mind. I misread that one. Jesus.
I thought it was a minute too. That's why I hold the. I had to think for like 5 seconds there. I didn't want to say.
Yeah,
it too
I never know if it's like that tick or that tick.
Yeah, same.
They gotta go for the Ember Spirit. No, not able to catch him out in time. What they could use is good old another Scythe of Ice on their team. I'm just not sure. Like, I guess it would have to be like Mapochka because I don't think Scandal's ever gonna get it. He's got too many items late game that he wants to get. Just completed the Octarine.
I mean, just give this Zeus a refresher and I see everybody melting.
Centaur stun! Oh, they got him. Finally. Danish Bears get something. I actually want to see how much that kill was worth. 398 for the Chen, but that was an absurd amount for a witch doctor. He lost 450, but they got 788 total for the team from that kill.
On oh, Hestia Joe.
Side. Is he
it's
dead?
Nice knowing you.
Dead, yeah. Ramsey's he's pretty much operating in a shooting gallery right now. He just kind of goes wherever he wants, does whatever he thinks is best, and gets kills constantly. Oh, he completes his Scotty for better stats.
Yep.
Didn't notice that one until now.
Yeah, it's also really good for going against the BKBs, too. Like, if maybe the Ember Spirit, the Juggernaut, want to kind of man fight him, like you said, it gives a lot of those stats. But it also gives the effect of, like, something piercing that BKB, you're not able to really run. And it's just an all-around good item. And then here he completes his Diffusal Blade, too. He has eyes on this Noya, and he's just dirt poor right now.
Run, Rubik, run! Oh, not death by Diffusal, or death by Mantas. Not death by Mantas, that's the worst way to go! Alright, Ryze gives him the save, but Scandal had his ultimate. There was definitely a point where Noya was low enough they could kill him.
Yeah, and Andy, the only reason why he lived there was the Voodoo Restoration Max coming in from Witch Doctor.
Yeah.
They put a ward down here from King R, kind of scouting out to see if Ace was there. Could have maybe made the play, but he's only got an Ags on the Witch Doctor. No creeps to really bounce to. Oh. Here we go.
Run around.
Earth Spirit Shadow Blade, man. That's what we like to see.
I mean, gotta find. It's kind of like the blink, another blink Scythe of Ice, right? Here, I was thinking super late game, and Poshka's like, no. If I just Shadow Blade and get right next to that Ember Spirit and get the silence, then we're fine. Because, again, Pinkvincheck, do you agree with his build, by the way, of going Daedalus and not going for, like, Manta to dispel the silence?
I mean, they lack a serious amount of damage in team fights, but I would agree, maybe get the crit to help farm a little bit better and get those crits going. But finishing the Daedalus, it's kind of questionable. He might still go for that Blink Dagger now, but if he does that, he's not going to have buyback. And yeah, what is he going to really do in the team fights once they just initiate on him with Spectre? I mean, one Haunt on top of him, he's forced to go back. He's not able to stay in the team fight, so still needs that BKB.
Afterlife looking for the Blink Scythe, gets him. Spectre ultimate comes out. Oh, man. Oh, man, Darkseer wasn't even close to anybody there. Like, most of his team was kind of lagging behind, but just one Scythe of Ice stun, or Hex, rather, and Ramsey's popping the ultimate. That's going to be enough to get the Ember Spirit to buy back. Now, Empire can check out the Roshan pit again, which they'll be happy to see is alive. Get the Aegis, push in while Ember Spirit doesn't have buyback.
I mean, this is more like a moral victory for Empire. They're just, like, trashing Danish Bears right now. They're, like, saying, you still have zero hope in this game. We're just going to back out, make sure you make some more mistakes and get more on tilt for the next game. That's how I feel they're playing right
Prepare
now.
Prepare to lose to Shadowblade Earth Spirit. Chasing down
Hested
Joe. Well. Another moral victory, right? You could screw up the engagement that badly. Not even hit your ultimate and still easily kill the Furion.
They're just rolling right now. And Danish Bears, I wonder how much beating Radiant's they can really take. One more attack. Pick off on Penguin here in the bottom lane, and it's over. And with that buyback, it just kind of seals the game because he has to have that item progression that we talked about. And when I spoke about the Blink Dagger earlier, Noya is going to be dead here. Really soon, but just what is this guy right now? 0-8. Oh, hard life. But yeah. Penguin, he
it's
needs to
great.
Just yeah. Going back to that Blink Dagger, it wasn't the best when I kind of said it at first. I mean, the Blink would help for the positioning, but when Zeus ulti comes out, Spectre Haunt, you can't really use it. So He still needs that BKB. Very far off from it. And just the item progression is not there. So Empire just going to wait out this next Aegis. And it should just be over after this.
Yeah, it really should be. 11 deaths on Furion. 0, 8, and 8 on the Rubick. The only one who looks okay is Ace, and that's solely because he's able to spin TP out of most engagements.
It was just that good combo kind of in the bottom when he got that triple kill, but ever since then, it's been Empire.
Yeah. So there's the Aegis. Ramsey's got rid of his drums. Wait, what? Oh, he got rid of his boots as well. So he's going to be a walking tank with no boots and picking up the butterfly. Here I was thinking, oh, yeah, he drops his drums, picks up the Aegis, goes from there, but nah. Ramsey's Rise. Like max stats, max tank. Spectral up. All right, no, he is dead. Ace is going to be chased down, but he should
escape.
Oh, no, he doesn't have a TP. Oh, dear. Why doesn't he carry a TP?
I mean, he had the gen. Okay, so Rubick died, and then he picked up or traded the TP.
Uh-huh.
And then that gem forced him to die holding on to it.
Bad decisions. Bad decisions were made. Dire's
structures are fortified. Are there really decisions?
I mean, Juggernaut's dead for 70 seconds. I don't know how you don't just like end this game as Empire at this point.
I don't know how you just don't call GG at this point. I mean, well, does he have buyback? No, 60 gold. That's about... What?
Oh, yeah. Maybe that's what they're waiting on. They think they can actually buy back on the Juggernaut. Just got to wait out the tick gold timing. Penguin check, though. Can't afford to die before the Juggernaut's here. Will be able to survive, get some damage. Good damage on King R2. The ultimate goes down. They're trying to blow up the Rubick. Not enough damage, though. Two lanes of racks down. Juggernaut no longer needing to buy back. Okay. Witch Doctor may have gotten the Rubick, but gives Pingvin check the kill. And Empire, solely because there's still a tier 2 at the top lane, will back up. And Juggernaut will be able to keep his gold intact.
That should help Penguin get with that Witch Doctor kill. He should be able to get his BKB now, but the problem will still be that blink initiation that we've been seeing with the Darkseer. Afterlife has been playing amazing for these last 10-15 minutes. I mean, they just all kind of came together, and it's a very simple lineup to kind of run. And yeah.
Very easy to execute once you get about 25 minutes in.
Yep.
Ramsey's not going to jump anywhere else.
Should have went for the throne play. Kill them all on the throne.
I mean, he's almost strong enough to do that.
I think he is. Maybe just wait out the Aegis, get a refresher, and then buy back.
Yeah.
So you have, like, just run in the fountain, then, or actually just ulti, go in the fountain, die, refresh, go back into the fountain. Top lane. Stun? Are they going to get Penguin? Doesn't look like it now.
Oh, why didn't he just jump back?
I don't know, man.
If the Witch Doctor is initiating on you, you got to know there's some sort of follow-up. It's not like Witch Doctor is thinking, I'll get him with a paralyzing cast combo stun into Death Ward. I'll solo kill this Ember Spirit. You know there's more heroes coming. You know what's happening.
I mean, he's been caught out by the Darkseer Sheepstick, you know, 3 or 4 times already. That's,
yeah.
It's one of those situations in the later stage of the game. Sometimes you can't check the enemy items in time when they're on the map, or they just sometimes, you know, have the item at a certain time. It's like the Blink Dagger coming out first on the Batrider. You're like, oh, you got me that first time, but, you know, still shame on you for getting picked off over and over again when that potential is there.
Look at it go!
Give me death in the fountain.
No. Oh.
If you die in the fountain, should you spawn outside? Radiant's middle tower
has fallen. And there it is. Danish Bears finally call it. Their GG doesn't even go off in time. The throne explodes first because Empire just that farmed. But a very rough game for Danish Bears. Real, what can we kind of point to as issues for Danish Bears? What did they really fail to execute in the early game here?
I think, like you said, put more pressure on Scandal so he doesn't have his, you know, Sol Ring and Aether Lens by the time they're trying to mow down the Tier 2 towers. And then that one fight in the bottom lane, Tier 2, where, you know, you have the Juggernaut. You feel so safe on the front lines, and then all of a sudden you have Mimposhka show up with his Air Spirit, get the best initiation in the world, blow them up in time. They even had the Chen mechanism online then, but they didn't have that extra oomph, like the Chen Hand of God. And then they were forced after that to play what I said. They're forced to play for the 60-70 minute game where they're trying to outcarry the Spectre with an Ember Spirit and a Juggernaut, and it just doesn't work out like that because of their global strategy. Mm-hmm. So really well played from Empire, and I don't know, Cap. I don't know if Danish Bears can win this next game, but their lineup, it was almost really well executed. Maybe the Ember Spirit didn't do enough, or you think that pick was fine, or?
I would say I don't know. I think the picks were kind of fine. I wasn't a big fan of the Rubik, but whatever, we said it comboed with the Chen. I think it was more just execution.
I think it was execution.
I'm really side with you on your breakdown of the game, but I guess we'll see. Danish Bears, you know, brush it off. It was just game number one. This is a best of three. They had their chance to come back after a short break. We'll have game number two.